crossword fans. Today, we're going to be solving the New York Times crossword for Friday, October 21st, 2022. All right, let's get started. One across, company that acquired Skype in 2005. Didn't Microsoft buy Skype? Maybe this is before that happened. It's not like eBay or something, is it? College Athletics Channel. Isn't that ESPNU? Ties for Vaqueros. Is this Bolo ties? Is it gonna be Bolos? Those letters look pretty good. Maybe it is eBay. That was kind of a wild guess. Pigeon pose for one. I'm gonna go ahead and guess that this is a yoga asana. I've never heard of the pigeon pose before. Opposite of flatline. Is this about having a good heartbeat? That seems a little weird. What are these acrosses? Okay, that's so-so. Oh, maybe it's just a yo-yo. That would be the opposite of a flat line. Yeah, that would be an oscillating line. Act casual. That's gotta be play it cool. What is this? The other one? And this is an equivalent phrase. No, not that, maybe? Might as well try another equivalent phrase. It can't hurt? Yeah, that's a very good equivalent. What aspirin can prevent? It's not an ache. What is this? Dried chili. Is that ancho? Weaselly animal. That's gonna be a stoat. Go, the light turned. And this is a bracket clue, so this is gonna be some kind of nonverbal form of communication. I would really want this to be a car honk or a beep. Is it a toot? A car horn toot? Unadon ingredient. I've never heard of this before. It looks kind of Japanese though. Help out with Thanksgiving dinner in a way. Is this gonna be based? You're basting the tofurkey before it goes in the oven? Pirouetting, say. That's gotta be on toe as a ballerina. Dark hue named after a type of glassware. That's gotta be bottle green, right? Excellent. Boo, is that a bay? A very modern pet name. Angler Supply, I'm not gonna know that one. Hold up, yet another equivalent phrase. Look at this long stack of acrosses here. Shouldn't this be hang on a second? Nice. Don't move, yet another equivalent phrase. It seems like we have a bit of an equivalent phrase theme today. Maybe this isn't quite an unthemed Friday puzzle. Don't move. I think it has to end in right there. Oh, that doesn't fit. It's not halt right there. That doesn't quite work, does it? Sebaceous. Sebaceous is a word that means oily. Many a promoter of human rights or voting rights, for short. Maybe this could be an NGO, a non-governmental organization. Currency whose symbol is, whatever this is, a bee with a strike through it. I wonder if that's the Thai baht. That would be a good guess, just because it starts with a B. Manhattan purveyor? So this is somebody that sells a Manhattan? Maybe that's a bar. A Manhattan is a kind of cocktail. Accelerated in a way. Accelerated. Does it start with fast? Posture that might be hard to maintain. Are we talking about an asana? I kind of doubt it. Destination, that could be end. Load. This is very ambiguous. This could be a noun, it could be a verb. It could be a lot of something, maybe it's a ton. Excessively admiring. I would want this to end in on or over, like doting on or fawning over. That doesn't really fit though. that's all, goodbye. Here's another equivalent phrase. Is it gonna end in gone? It's not I'm gone. It could end in gone though. Maybe we're gone? It could be plural. Blank bowling. Is that lawn bowling? Headlight, and this is wordplay. So this is not a headlight on a car. Maybe it's a light bulb going off above your head. That could be an idea. That's a nice pun. When repeated, a 2010s dance move. That is the nene. Mauve relative. Okay, mauve is a color. I think it's kind of a purplish color. Could this be lilac? I think that makes sense. The Solomon lilies smell of rotting fruit to flies. Is that a lure to flies? Hayride seat, that's gonna be a bale of hay. Excessively admiring, that's gonna be adulation. There we go. Okay, so what is this? Posture that might be hard to maintain. It ends in cage? Maybe age. What in the world is this? Uncapped, and this is more wordplay. So this is not unlimited, maybe? Maybe it's about something that's literally not capped, like a bottle. Or maybe it's about someone who doesn't have a hat on? Could that be bareheaded? That's pretty good. What is this, posture? Maybe it's a figurative posture, like a behavior. That's tricky. Don't move. It is gonna be right. Oh, wait a minute, this can't be adulation. That's not spelled correctly. Maybe it's adulatory. Wow. Maybe this is right here. It's not sit right here or stay right here. Large Hadron Collider org. That's gonna be CERN. Yeah, that's a big particle accelerator in Europe. What is this next long across here? Make dough from scratch. And this is wordplay, it's not another equivalent phrase. Okay, so this is not about making bread dough from scratch. I think this is gonna be about making money from a scratch-off lottery ticket. This is gonna be win the lottery. That's really funny, I like that one. Word with horse or hero. War horse, war hero. So what? Here's our equivalent phrase. That could be and. What an investor hopes for. You always want to get a return on your investment. Place to store some barrels. Well, it looks like it's going to start with wine, but it's not a wine cellar. What kind of wine place is this going to be? Stable youth. And this is more wordplay. Wow, the amount of wordplay on this puzzle has been great. So this is not going to be about a person that is stable when they're young. I think this is going to be about a young animal that could be in a stable. That could be a colt. That's a young horse. It's not a wine cask. That's another kind of barrel. That doesn't make sense. Item often seen in home bathrooms, but rarely in public ones. Is it a hand towel? Yeah, you don't see those in public bathrooms. They parallel radiuses. I think this is talking about the bone in your arm. This could be ulna, plural. It's shortest at the equator. What is that talking about? Is it dawn? Dawn is short at the equator? That doesn't make sense to me. Equator. Why is this capitalized? Is the equator always capitalized? Sclera neighbor. Okay, the sclera is part of your eye. So I think this is gonna be the uvea, that's another part of your eye. Comes together. What is this? Vibed with. This seems a little strange. Is this a wine cave? I don't think I've ever heard of that before. This is looking like dawn. Is that right? Vibed. This has to be in the past tense. Comes together. Oh, maybe this is ulnas with an S. Oh, man. Okay, so this should be gels, right? And this is dug. There we go. That's in the past tense. Dawn is shorter at the equator. Wow. Okay, well, hopefully the goose explained how that's possible. Accelerated in a way. Okay, this looks like it needs to be fast-tracked. There we go. And this is going to be wait right there. That finally makes sense. All right, we just have this last corner here. Necklace bit. That's going to be a bead in book form. I think this has to be bound. It's bound up like a book. World-weary feeling. That's definitely ennui, the feeling of world weariness. Orchestrated performances, and this is more wordplay. So this is not about some kind of play that someone is putting on. I wonder if it's literally about an orchestra performance. Orchestrated performances. I don't know exactly what this is gonna be. Buzzes while buzzed, more wordplay. I don't really know what the standard reading of this would be. Buzzes. I want it to be about getting a buzz off of alcohol. Yeah, drunk something. Oh, it's about calling while you're buzzed. It's going to be drunk dials. That's really, really funny. You're calling someone while you're buzzed. Feature of some TVs for short. That's got to be a DVR. Where it's at. The venue is where a performance is at. Maybe an orchestral performance? I guess we'll see. Updated as a kitchen that's redid. We redid our kitchen. Native Canadian is a Cree. It is a concert, right? Maybe it's concertas? Yeah, those would be orchestrated performances. They'd be performed by an orchestra. Red maybe. Is this about being angry? Riled? That doesn't quite fit. Folded in French. I wonder if we're going to be familiar with this word. Yeah, I wonder if we'll recognize this. Red. Where the piano was invented. It looks like it's going to be Italy. For real? Maybe our last equivalent phrase. I don't know about this one. Blank flash. In a flash? What is this? For real? Shouldn't that be no lie? So maybe this is concertos. So this is no lie. Jacks are male ones. And Jennies are female asses. Yeah. Folded. This isn't looking like anything. Sizes up should be eyes. And then, is this rile? It can't be. Red. Maybe that's ripe, as an apple would be. And this is plié? Oh, that's like a move in ballet, right? Folded? Maybe they're talking about folding your legs in a plié? Yeah, let's throw that P in there and see if that'll do it for us. Ooh, gee whiz, we have a square wrong? Let me see if I can track this down. Ooh, wait a minute. My eyes immediately went to this very strange entry, façade. Façade is not something I've ever heard of, but a façade, yeah, a kind of pretense, that could be a kind of a posture, right? That's a front that you're putting up. And then this could be we're done. That makes a lot of sense. All right, let's throw this D in there and see if that will, in fact, do it for us. All right, a Friday puzzle in 24 minutes. That's still a very quick Friday time, even taking into account a whole bunch of cat interruptions today. I'll let my cat Tybalt say hello to you all really quickly. There she is, the little rascal. All right, let's take a look at this grid. I thought this was a really excellent puzzle. This had a whole bunch of kind of marquee long answers that were either equivalent phrases like hang on a second for hold up, or really fun wordplay clues win the lottery, make dough from scratch. That is super, super clever. I also really liked drunk dials, buzzes while buzzed. That is really fun. Yeah, so many equivalent phrases today. No, not that. It can't hurt. Wait right there. Man, and we're done, I guess appropriately enough, as we've reached the end of our solve. But I hope you enjoyed solving that one along with me. I'm gonna be coming back at you tomorrow for the most challenging puzzle of the week, the Saturday. And I think that's gonna do it for now. All right, I'll see you next time.